There is this new typical question of law has arisen before me today. It was asked by a client of mine in a new case. And this involves a very typical situation of law, very typical question of law. So I thought of sharing it with you guys. So today this person came to me. He told me that his brother is involved in a case. His anticipatory bail is pending before the Honorable High Court, but the investigation is also pending. And during this process itself, he has been declared proclaimed offender. Now, the first question that he asked me was whether a person who has filed anticipatory bail, can he be declared a proclaimed offender? Second question he asked me was, when an anticipatory bail is pending and this person has been declared proclaimed offender, now can the anticipatory bail be granted in this kind of cases? Before I answer these questions, let's go through the basic facts of this case. The FIR was registered in 2019. He filed an anticipatory bail before the Court of Session, which was dismissed. During this period, lockdown was imposed by the government itself. And after 2020 is gone, he approached the Honorable High Court of Delhi for the grant of anticipatory bail. During this entire period, the police got active. They got NBWs issued against this person, but he did not join investigation. So the PO proceedings were initiated by the concerned magistrate. While his anticipatory bail was pending before the Honorable High Court, he was declared proclaimed offender. So to answer the first question, I told him that the investigation is the right of the police. Power of the police to investigate should not be hampered. So they approached the concerned magistrate for issuance of the NBWs. The concerned magistrate directed this person to be arrested. The police was not able to trace him out. Later on, a publication was made in the newspaper and he was declared a proclaimed offender. So yes, a person whose anticipatory bail is filed or is pending before the concerned court, until or unless there is an order of not taking any coercive action against this person, and in case there is no interim protection, any accused can be declared a proclaimed offender. To answer his second question, I explained him, look, when a person files an anticipatory bail, at the time of granting or dismissing the bail application, the court has to consider three things. First, whether this person would be available at the time of trial. So, are there any chances of running away? Second, are there any chances that this person might try to tamper the evidence or try to threaten the witnesses or induce the witnesses to change their story or their statement? And third, whether this person is ready and willing to join the investigation, and to make sure that this person should be available at the time of trial, he should not hamper the investigation process, he should not threaten or induce the witnesses, and he should not run away, the court always imposes certain conditions. So the first thing that court has to see is whether this person will be available at the time of trial or not. And declaration of a person as a proclaimed offender is totally opposite to his intention of being readily available at the time of trial. So, in this kind of situation, when a person is declared proclaimed offender, there is an apprehension that this person might run away. There are chances the police will not be able to trace him out at the time of trial or during investigation. There are chances that he might not be available at the time of trial. He might not appear before the concerned court. So this presumption is taken against this person because he has been declared a proclaimed offender. In this kind of situation, grant of anticipatory bail, basically if you file an anticipatory bail before the Court of Session or the High Court, it becomes difficult. But that does not make an innocent person to go behind bars. There have been different orders by the Honorable Supreme Court and Honorable High Court and other High Courts also. So these observations of various high courts can be summarized as that when a case has been registered against a person and it is a cognizable case, that means the police can arrest that person without warrant. Second, if it is a non-bailable one, then the police has no power to grant or release any person on bail. So there is always the Article 21 is there, which protects the life and liberty of every person, every citizen. So a person against whom there is an apprehension that he might be arrested in non-bailable offense, and he files an anticipatory bail. So definitely this person will try to stay away from the police, because in case the police arrests this person during this anticipatory bail proceedings, then his entire right under Article 21 and his right to be heard at the anticipatory bail proceedings and to get the anticipatory bail in his favor, that right becomes infructuous. I specifically told him that although it is difficult, but there have been cases where anticipatory bail has been granted to proclaimed offender. First, a person can be declared proclaimed offender in case the anticipatory bail is pending. Second, this person can be released on anticipatory bail even though he has been declared proclaimed offender. Given he is able to satisfy the honorable court, the concerned court, that he will be readily available at the time of trial. He will join the investigation, he is willing to join the investigation, and there are no chances that he will tamper with the evidence. If you have any questions related to this kind of situation, you can ask me in the comment box. I'll try to answer them as soon as possible and as accurately as possible.